Hello everyone, this is Martha, Seeking for Art. Everybody knows me on the web, Seeking for Art, and I'm originator of a melted crayon technique. Something that happened on an accident, a happy accident, but I've been so happy that it happened to me. So, and I'm starting to show some of my paintings that I have done with melted crayon. And today we're gonna be doing a little project. I'm making a coaster. And yeah, happy birthday, Darcy. This is your day all day. It's also Sandy. Oh, happy birthday, Sandy. Oh, hi, Sherry. I didn't see you come in. So, right now I'm doing a little show and tell of all the different things I've done with the melted crayon. And sirens going around. Sorry, girls. We have the windows open. And this is one my last painting I've done. So this is my fishy. This is daddy fish, mama fish, baby fish. Police coming to get me. No, I haven't been drinking, so they don't have no say. So I'm reading the chat, that's why I get quiet. Yep, yeah, here, fishy. So anyways, this is my little show and tell, I guess. So, anyways. So yes, darn, these are the cards you're gonna be getting this month. I think tomorrow we do the exchange. So we're gonna get together tomorrow with the ladies, the local ladies here, and this is the cart. So let me put everything away because the table gets smaller by the minute. Yeah, right. Happy birthday, gang. There were a lot of birthdays this month. Thanks, Darcy. Yes, this was a steampunk. When I saw it, I said, I'm sending this one to Dar. Yes, she did. Dar, she show you that the one, and I have mine right here too. This is the one that Dar made for me at the retreat. And of course, I had to have Crayola on it. And it's gorgeous. So is it a lag? I guess I see some people. Yeah, she is amazing. I think when we were in Austin, and the guy asked, what are you guys doing playing bingo? I was getting ready to say, you just don't know how much talent is in this room. It's so much talent in this room. We had a mix of everything, and everybody is just so good at everything they do. That's what is so great about this group. That we, you know, from making mini books, cards, quilting, sewing, painting. Oh, thank you, Darcy. So, it's just so much talent. You know what? And I apologize, guys, because I don't have that much time. So when I came back from Austin, I went to work the next day, and I put everything away so quickly, and I wasn't thinking about, you know, do a show and tell from all the goodies I got. I was just so rushed that I need to get back to work, and I start unpacking my clothes and putting everything. Actually, the clothes went straight to the laundry. So let me put everything away. Yeah, Dara made another book for Bryn. So oh, somebody has a headache. So, anyways, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do. I'm not sure. I see a lag in the chat, so I'm not sure if it's my video or if. So, I'm not really sure what I'm doing because I don't have a sample. So, I wasn't really. I wasn't really going to stream today, but since Dar's not feeling good, and I hope you're feeling better, Dar. That's not fun to be sick. So I'm going to wait so you guys can tell me which one. But which one would like me to do or the coaster? So these are the choices. Yeah, because that seemed like somebody just making comments on certain things that I did like 5 minutes ago. So I'm not sure if it's a lag or what's going on. So Bar wants butterflies. Somebody wants the head. Uh-oh. Somebody wants the grandma bird. Oh, never mind. Never mind. No choices. I'm gonna close my eyes and pick. Oh, I know this is the bird. I can feel it. I'm gonna do the head. Oh, I can do another one. It doesn't matter. I do the birdie. If I can find my, I had everything here. Oh, here we go. Okay, bird. I'm doing the bird. Everybody happy? And to get started, I don't know how many of you have done melted crayon, but I guess I'm going to start from the basics again. So, of course, we're going to need a stamp. Your favorite stamp, and when you just do a melted crayon, this is my what I prefer, but I know you can use India ink or you can use it stays on, but when I really want details, I use Versafine. So this is my preferred ink to do the technique. But that doesn't mean that you guys can experiment with others. For this project, I'm going to also use Versamark because we're going to be using UT. So we're going to be using UT. So we guys gonna need this too. And Bristol board. You can use Bristol Bell. It doesn't really make a difference. You can also use craft paper, as long as it's not glossy. So this is a must. Hi, Vicky. What else am I using today? I'm using chipboard, and this is very thin. Oops, got a bag here. So this is a very thin chipboard. You can use any type of chipboard, doesn't really matter. Oop, sorry. White. And then we have the cork. And I can post the link for the cork. Let me see if I can find it. Hold on a second. I have to bring everything back. Hold on. There we go. Okay, so here's the link for the cork. And it's a sticky back, so I'm trying not to show the white too much because then my camera goes crazy. Alright, what else do we need? Of course, we're gonna need crayons. And guess what? I need an eraser. And I didn't get one out. Hold on a second. You need an eraser. And I'm not sure if this eraser is gonna work. I just have a pencil eraser. I usually use a white eraser. If you don't mind my reaching, I need to find out if I have one out here. Hold on. This is my this is my bag, and this is Mitzi, little doll. Oops, isn't she cute? She's hold on, there she is. My little doll we made with Mitzi in Austin, and everybody has seen it probably. So. And I do have an eraser, so hold on a second. Let me take it out. So this is usually the eraser I use. Just a white eraser. So, what else do we need? We need Prisma pencils. So, everybody's talking about food. And of course, crayon. So, those are the materials. So, you guys let me know if I skip a step or something. No, I'm not explaining a step the way I should. So we're gonna start with I cut this Bristol board 3¾ by 3¾, and the reason I did it because that was the size of the cork. So if you can find bigger cork, you know, you can do a 4x4 or 5x5. So that was the reason I had to cut 3½ by 3½. So anyways, so I usually try to find the smoothest, because it has two sides, believe it or not. It doesn't really matter. By mistake, I have used the other side, so just a smooth area. Usually by touch, you can tell which side is the smoother than the other one. And my brand new ink pad. Because usually all my ink pads are really, really, look. This is a used ink pad. See how bad it gets? So I'm using a new one today. So I'm going to put the stamp on my plate. I'm going to ink my stamp. I'm going to put my, you also need some newsprint. This is from the kids area, so this is not the artist grade of newsprint, but it's just going to be for, oops, birdie fell off. Okay, here we go. You also need an iron, and this is a traveling iron, and see it has holes, but it's okay because I only use it for melted crayon. I have so many different irons, but I prefer this one. I usually use this one the most. So I'm going to turn it on about probably medium. This one doesn't say medium, it says wool, but that's what I'm going to stick with. So what we're going to do, we're going to do kind of a resist technique using the pencils. And let me see, I thought I had some new pencils. Another here. Just came. Oh, here we go. I'll put them right here. This is the ones we got in Austin. And I have had another set. I had a set of 12, but they were broken. I bought them for like $1 at Michael's. They were broken. And I just bought them just to try them. And I really, really, I think I love this one. I prefer this one's better than the Prismas. The only thing, the Prisma has more colors. This one only comes in 24, so. So, anyways, so you guys have questions, just be sure you put the question mark as I'm going, so. Okay, so let me see, I don't know what color I'm going to paint the bird. I guess I can do brown. Maybe a little bit of orange. What the heck? Well, I'm gonna be using probably blue for background, so I don't know if I'm not missing anything on the chat. This is what gets scary when you try to do something on camera and you hope it turns out, because I didn't practice. So this is a little bit kind of impromptu for me, so we'll see what happens. I'm trying to look for a different tone of brown. So I'm still a little, I'm sideways, so I'm gonna try to. Can you guys see okay? Do you need me to get more close up? wet vinyl pencils, Eileen. It doesn't really matter. I mean, you can actually even use Crayola pencils. They just have to be wax based. This one, I have two kinds right now. So, look at, where are these? These are the woodless pencils. This one comes in a set of 24. I don't know, it just seems, well, they don't break as much as the Prisma break. The Prisma, you can, you sharpen and sharpen the pencil, and it seems like it keeps breaking every time I try to. So that's the only reason I like this ones, because they're real creamy, and also they don't break as much when you try to sharpen the pencil. Thank you, Darcy. I know, I'm an enabler, right? But we wouldn't be happy if we didn't have it. Oh, I'm not sure if they say they wax base. Let me see. I'm trying to read. No, it doesn't really say. Yeah, as long as they don't say the watercolor pencils, I think you're fine. You know, if they say the watercolor pencils, then you won't be able to use them. So anyways, do I need to get closer? Is anybody able to answer me? Gel birdie, but I'm just saying, is the camera close enough, or do I need to get a little bit closer? And the reason I have all this nonsense here, because I'm trying to stay focused. Okay, so you guys can see fine. All right, well, I'm gonna do probably blue as my background, so I'm gonna try to use contrast colors. And yeah, yellow will probably be pretty. As long as it's not, there we go. Do you need me to get a little closer? Okay, hold on. Just need to move. Let's see, the camera is in an angle. Can never get this camera. Is that okay? Is this okay? Is this better? Well, let me see if I can get even closer than this. It just, I don't want to be distorted. That's the only. I'm not as fancy as Barb with all her high tech. I think I need to move this way. Okay. So here we go. I'm gonna try to be in an angle so I don't have my hand on the camera and you guys can't see. Alrighty. So I'm gonna do, usually I work from my lightest to my darkest. So let me see if I can, I don't wanna have my hand on the way. So I'm just showing a little highlights. And you can hardly see because it's white, I know. And this one gonna need some white. So just remember, if you want some white to show before you put the melted crayon, you have to be sure that
you press hard.
Oop, I've been doing it again. You have to press really hard and be sure the whole thing is covered. Even if you see that the ink kind of smear a little bit, it doesn't really matter. I mean, a lot of people were like, Martha, but my ink is smearing. I said, it doesn't really matter. So don't be afraid. Even if it looks that it smears because of the pencils, it's fine. So. So I'm even using a little bit of orange. Every time I'm on camera, I feel like I need to rush. But I guess I need to take my time. Wait, I need a little bit of white here before I get on the brownish. And if you make a mistake, that's what erasers are for. Okay, so bird, it's just color. We all can color. Just back to our elementary days, right? So, we still want to show some, so I'm just going to put a little bit more color here. I know it's hard to see, I'm sorry. But I know everybody knows how to color. Right? Oops. Okay, so this step is done. So this is just coloring. Nothing to it. Now the next thing was going to be to use the melted crayon. So now I have to choose what color I'm going to use for background. always, you can always try it to see. This is a little more aqua, but it'll be okay. You can always use white if you want, if you don't want your colors to be too dark. Just like mixing paints. And this is periwinkle. So this thing is to unwrap the crayons. Okay. That's my daughter. Hold on a second. Sorry about that. Oh, you hear the birds singing? Yep. Yep. I'm surrounded by trees, so that's where my shed is at. So I like to open the windows now and hear them. And I'm doing a birdie. So I'm going to get this cleaned up now. Trying to be sure I get a good angle. So here's my card. Yeah, she was texting me. She doesn't talk to me. She texts me. So this is a little aqua. And I'm going to use periwinkle. And a little bit of green. So, and also white. Text me again, sorry. Okay, let me see where I can get this. There we go. This is the iron, and it's hot, and I usually test it with my fingers. Of course, I need to get them a little bit wet. It is hard. I usually blend my colors, and I usually grab two or three at the same time, depending on what I'm doing. There are times I only use one at a time, but it doesn't really matter. It's whatever you feel comfortable. I've been doing this for a while, so. So. I'll melt the crayon. And I'm going to use a little bit of white. And it rusts. It doesn't really matter. It's random. So you're going to paint your card. It's only one stroke. It's not like ironing. It's like painting. It's one stroke. So you turn over your iron and you use one or two strokes at the most. I've seen a lot of people that trying to do this, and you don't do that because if you have different colors, all you're gonna do is just melt them. Mix them like mud. So. Yes, Archie, it's easier for you to use one at a time. It's whatever you feel comfortable. But I'm brave. I'm brave. Like I told Dar, if I screw it up, I'll fix it tomorrow. So, like I said again, it's one stroke. Okay, and here I want it darker, so I'm going to use just the blue. So I'm going to use one color there. So I'm going to put my iron a little bit higher. Really wet? Do you think it was? So, this is after the crayon. And for that, oops, get focused. Can I get in focus? There we go. Gonna need paper towel. It's another tool I forgot to mention. You need a paper towel. Next thing we're gonna, I might get a little bit out of focus, so I'm gonna put this right here. So I don't wanna get out of focus. So you turn it over, you heat it again. And then you're gonna wipe off the excess of the wax. So you see how the colored pencils kinda did a resist. And you see how the blue got in the crevices that I probably didn't color hard enough. So you see some of that blue, but it's okay. That's part of the technique. Oh, you say my fingers are wet on it? Yeah, they're wet. So that's part of the technique. See how the blue got on all the little crevices? That's part of the technique. You want that mix. You want those colors to get in there and blend with the other ones. And there's sometimes when you think, or there sometimes you don't want that, that's when you can use the eraser. And the eraser would get rid of some of that blue if you needed to. And then it's, there are times that you feel like, you know, that color got in a place I didn't want it to. Then you can go back. Or you don't think that color is nice enough, you can go back and color it again. So it's very forgiving. Yeah, it's a very smooth finish. So, and a lot of times if you want to seal it, you can seal it with gel medium or, you know, gloss gel medium or any type of glaze, diamond glaze. I know, I feel like I keep going over and over the technique with you guys. Especially the ones that were in Austin, you know, it's like, I don't know how many times we've done this, right? So, the next step will be, so now you have your chipboard, and all we're going to use is just going to quick adhesive. And the reason I didn't adhere first, because I was afraid when I heat it up, you know, I couldn't turn it over and heat it up. So that was the reason I didn't adhere it beforehand. So I'm gonna glue it. You always learn something. I'm glad. because I feel like I keep repeating myself. Oh, really? This is the first time you've seen it, Carrie? Oh, no problem. Like I said, this is an original technique that I kind of found out by mistake. I haven't seen nobody, and I did research today if anybody has done coasters with UT, and I didn't find anybody. So I saw some UT in tiles, I think. So, but I think you guys are getting something original today. And something that you probably have not seen it. If you've seen it, I mean, this technique has been out for a while. I did it at ATC's For All. I had a whole post on it. I did workshops with them, and I have done it with this group also. So, anyways. So now this is glue. And what I love about it, this sticky back cork, that you don't have to mess with glue. So we're gonna let it get dry and we can work on something else. And I wanted to show you the technique to do faces, and that was the reason I had this one. That was the reason. I knew I had it out for a reason. So I'm trying to find, sorry for my reaching, because I got the chipboard is white, so I have to be careful not to use the chipboard when I'm stamping. So I'm going to use the face. Just because I want to show you guys another little trick. I was trying to show it in Austin, but I don't think if I got it true. So anyway, so we'll see what happens here. So imagine yourself, you drew a face or you're just doing a stamp. It doesn't really matter. But you wanna do the face with crayon. To me, it's the fastest way sometimes to color a face. Kind of like, let me see, I want to show you guys before. Kind of like her. Okay? Yeah, I was published in Somerset. So anyways, so if you want to do a face like this, if you do it in acrylics, this takes forever. And I did use some acrylic, like her lips, because I really wanted her lips to pop out and her eyes. But usually I can do a face with melted crayon much faster than I can do the skin tone and everything else than I can do with acrylics. Not that I cannot do acrylics, I can also do acrylics, but Bebon, I think I missed one of your questions. If you add more pencil, do you iron that off? No, if I add more pencil, I leave it on. It's just to, if something didn't look right or it didn't look the way I wanted it, I can always go back with pencils. Like when we were doing Darcy started doing it with doing the face with pencil, and then I told her you can do that with the crayon. And so then the pencil and the crayon had, you can tell the difference on them, where they started with where it started the pencil and where it started with the crayon. So we went back with the pencils and fixed the face. So we're gonna do the face, and again you're gonna start with your white, so you know where the white is gonna be. So of course the eye, and I might have to retouch it again later on, but for right now is fine. Just need to be sure. So you want to give a little bit of shadow. Pretty much this stamp is telling you where the shadows are. Well, don't be afraid to use also some other color that is not a skin tone. You can always use blues or purples or pinks for that matter. It doesn't really matter. Everything goes. Just like my shadow. Anything goes. So oh, you're welcome, Dar. So, yeah, always your eraser is your friend, and the pencils when you want to go back and fix a mishap. It's just a little mishap. And if it doesn't, they say, I meant to do that. I meant to do it. I don't even know what I'm going with this color, because this is the color I'm going to use. So anyways. So, yeah, Dar, you feeling better? All right, so we're gonna go with the step. So you see, I did some a little bit of shadowing, and also you can do highlights. I forgot to do highlights. Hold on a second. You can do a little bit of highlights. All right, so to do faces, we're not going to do the other thing. We're not going to put the crayon on the eye. What we're going to do, we're going to hit the paper. Let me see if I'm okay. So we're going to heat the paper and not just let it stay for a few seconds. Let it stay there for a few seconds. Just be sure it's nice and hot. Now we're going to take the crayon and melt it. See how easy that is? Anybody can do it, right? Is anybody following? It's still a lag. Okay. I'm just trying to show the technique on how to do a face. That's what I'm trying to accomplish with you guys. That you don't, if, because it's hard to put the crayon on the iron and then try to do the face, try to color the face. Or you can make it different colors too. I mean, it's okay too to do, if you want to do another technique where the face is all different colors. That's another different technique. So, because I usually this, to try to do a face with, like I said, with acrylics, it takes a lot of layers and layers and layers of paints and shadows and highlights, and you just work and work and work. And with this one, you can just heat it up. Hi Mitzi, no problem. You can just heat it up and just melt your melt the crayon. So I'm gonna get a little, right now it's playing time. What I'm trying to do is just so you guys can feel comfortable. I'm gonna use black because it's playing time. And it's like, oh no, black. I'm gonna use black. And right now I'm just doodling with white pens. And it's hard to see because it's white on white. So I'm gonna be a little bit brave today. Okay. I'm gonna miss this piece right here. Hi Myra. So we're gonna use black. And maybe a little bit of white. Where's my white? It went away. It's okay. I've never done this before. Never seen a tea. Not with the black anyways. And I'm trying to get here. So I'm just trying to be sure my iron is thoroughly clean. So I'm really trying to get on those crevices. So heat up the paper and then get your crayon. Let the crayon do the work for you. So is everybody following? Any questions? So, pretty bad, huh? Especially that black. Oh well. It's an experiment. So we're playing. This is in lieu because I'm just trying to get this one get dry. Because we already did most of the. So now we're going to try to heat it up again. And go from the dark, from the light to the dark. So I'm gonna do the face first. Oop, and I still got black. That's okay. And everybody would have been already, probably you guys would have been panicking. See, I got black on his face, or hers, or I got some of the black on the face. But it's okay. Just need to find my eraser. So this is when people get a little scared and then they give up and they say, well, that didn't work for me. Or, but look, the eraser is your friend if I can just get it clean enough. So I don't know if you guys saw, but I had a lot of smear black. I still have some right here. I still have some smear of the black. So that's when the eraser comes in to be able to help you out.
And the reason I'm doing that is pretty much for a demo. I don't want you guys to be scared. Be scared because I made a boo-boo, or I think, you know, put a darker color on top of the lay of the lighters, and so
see how all those black smears gonna went away. Oh, he looked like he was shedding a tear. I think so. I think I am recording. So, I know this probably, you know, this is just a demo, like I said. But I just wanted to show you guys that you can do a face. You can do almost anything with the crayon. And if you want more detail, then you can go back. You can go back with the pencils. And if you miss something, you can go back and give it more color. Or you can go back and add more light to the face. Or you can give it more shadow. Okay. Any questions? Oh, Bart. As long as they're wax-based color pencils, it doesn't really matter the brand. I'm not trying to sell the brand or anything. I own many of Prismacolors for years. So I started using the Prismas. And I found a set of this ones in 12 one time broken in Michael. So I was giving it a try and they work pretty good. And I like them better because they don't break. Not like the Prismas do. Yeah, and the eraser is going to be one of the best tools. Thank you, B Button. Yeah, this was I never really used black as a background, but I was just trying to show you guys that if you do put black, if you put a dark, you know, if you work your base, and even though, because it's hard to manipulate with the iron a lot of times, so if you, by mistake, put a darker color on top of your lighter color, the eraser is going to help you. So, and also with doing the white pencil so you guys can see how you can, you know, you can doodle and do different things with the pencils as your background. So... Yeah, I don't use black, you know, a lot, but I did one time. I just did the background in black with the crayon, and then I used, I was using acrylic, so I did a white horse, you know, on top of the black background, and it came stunning too. So, alright, so back to the project. That was just a demo for you guys. Here comes the messy part.
I'm gonna turn off the unless you guys request something else. I mean, I'm turning off the yarn just because I don't want to get burnt. So, I mean, I've done many other demos here in Ustream, so if the ones that haven't seen me before, you can go back. I have used some other mediums as a demo also. So, I'm just gonna do the corners look black. I should have done it. Okay, daughter is home. Yeah, because I'm not in the house. I'm in the backyard. Sorry. Pika. Trying to dry the ink. Yes, Bart, you can find many, many different things when you do the melted crayon. And I can do the basic one. So if anybody just wants to play and try to find images, I can do that one too. So next step, we're going to use Bursa Mark. And be generous, trying to cover the whole thing. Don't be generous too with the UT. It's up to you, Rusty. You can use any type of, it's what you feel comfortable with. You know, you can still, if you're just gonna start, whatever kind of stamp that you wanna use, just be sure you feel comfortable. If you get one with too much detail, you may get a little frustrated. So you can start simple and then work your way up. Faces, I think a lot of people get a little more, it's like a little more challenge, but they're not hard either. It's just building experience and confidence. That's all. So, here we go. We're going to use the heat gun again. just be sure it's melted everywhere. The UT's melted. So I'm gonna let it cool a little bit. And it has a lot of texture right now on the first. You can see the texture on the first go around. So you're gonna give it at least two. So you're gonna do this at least twice to be sure that you cover a lot of those crevices and it's waterproof. Oh, B Bun, I'm sorry. Yeah, Jean is right. First you use the Bursa mark, and I'm gonna do it again. It's getting a little off focus right now because I moved this. There we go. So I'm gonna do it again. I'm gonna repeat the same step. So you're gonna cover it completely with the Bursa mark. And like I said, be generous. And if you touch a corner or something, go back to it. So if you miss anything on the first go around, you can probably be able to catch it on the second time. And if you do, you can do a third time. So again, we're going to cover it with UT. And the table's getting smaller. There we go. Gonna use the heat gun again. I'm trying to put this mouse so I don't get out of focus. Got more crayon, Mitzi? Yeah, she said she got the triangular ones, the ones shaped as triangles. What is cool about those, and I don't have any, is that they don't, if you put them down, they don't roll. Sometimes this ones roll. And then you're like, wait, crayon, come back. So, here we go. We're going to use the heat gun. Yeah, who said somebody was going to get so ecstatic about finding a selling crayons, right? One. So here we go. See, it's not as texture as it was the first time. It still has some texture, but not as bad. So, I'm trying to see if I can, there we go. Yeah, still texture, but not so bad like it was the first time. You want a birdie, Dar? I'm not yet have one coaster for me, but that's okay. I say I can always make more.
So can you imagine? I mean, you can do this. You can do coasters for Valentine's Day, for Easter, for 4th of July, for any type of holiday, something inexpensive. I don't know, Christmas. So, yes, I know, Dar. I know it's a compliment. You know I do. So, anyways, like I said, yep, Christmas. So you can have coasters for different occasions, something inexpensive. Who could say, who will say that just was some crayons and stamps? You can do something like this. Yep. Yes, Jane. So did anybody get, did you guys get the link? And I don't have a stock on on the backs for the for the coasters. But if you would like to know the link where I got them from, I can share it with you. Yeah, this was something I did when we were in Austin. I've been doing these demos for quite a while. I think I started like in 2009 when we met at Indianapolis in ATCs for All or R for All retreat, and I did a class of 20 people. Then I did in Dallas. I had almost 30 people, which it wasn't fun. It was just too many to be able to keep track and help. But I did it, so I'm proud of it now. I've been sharing this online for quite a while. ATCs for All has a big long writing on the technique. So anybody interested, it's also it was also published, the technique was also published in Art Trader magazine. So I was published in, I think it was 2000, I can't remember, it was 2008 or 2009. I think it was probably 2008, because that was when I first came out with a technique and everybody wanted to know, so I had to wait a little bit and get it published on a magazine. It's on my blog too, so the link for the Art Trader magazine is on my blog. So if anybody wants to find it. All good, Mitzi. So, I mean, and then this is to get you started. For a while, I was trying every single thing that I can mix the melted crayon with, and so far, I know it's pencils, I know it's acrylic paints. I have not done it with oil paints yet, but I've done it with India ink. What else? I've done resist techniques. Like this is a resist technique. I'll be button, just you can just Google me on the same username. You'll find me is seekingforart.blogspot.com. So I will need to get out and to be sure that the link worked. Yep, seekingforartblogspot.com. So you can just Google me with a username. Just be sure seeking for R one word and you'll find me. You'll find all the other use streams. You find a few YouTubes probably. And that was with Happy Diane and Annette, the last ones I did. So any other questions? Does anybody wants to know more? Or I can also let me see if I can find the Art Trader magazine. Let me just try to find it and up with that link too for if I can type and excuse my reaching. Is the Art Trader magazine issue 4? I just need to find it. Hold on a second. I'm looking. There we go. I found it. So here's the link to the magazine. You can download it. It's on PDF. And do the find something technique. Ooh, that's putting me on the spot. Have you mixed beeswax? Yeah, I have used to use beeswax on. When I try to give her a shine, I sometimes do put beeswax, but I try not to. I usually use it when I want to do maybe like a napkin. You know, I do the melted crayon background and then use napkins. So that's also a new stream if you guys want to see that. So, oh, thank you, Jeanette. So, the Art Trader magazine has a step-by-step the technique, and I just need to find. I can't remember what page it was. Let me hold on. It was page 9 on the Art Trader magazine. The pure pigments. Not sure what kind of pigments. Mitty. Yeah, I'm on page 9 on that Art Trader magazine. So, you want me to do find faces or find something, or like I said, that's putting me on the spot. That's not fair, but it's for fun. I mean, I don't want to keep you guys. I was trying to cover Dar's time. So, not even buy the pigments, Misty. Yeah, they were just too expensive. And I said I can order them online, but I haven't been able to find them now. So, I probably need to call the store and ask them what was exactly the name of them, because I didn't write it down. I didn't take a picture. I wasn't thinking. I was too excited being in Austin. Story of my life. So, hi, Carol. So, here we go. I need to heat up the yarn again, so it only takes a few minutes. All good, Midnight. Yeah, no work tomorrow, you're right. Oh, Photo Joy, you lost connection. And you know what, Mitzi? I do have some pigments, but they're powder type, and I was thinking about mixing them with wax. So I'll probably try to experiment and see what happens. I'm too shy to experiment online. So what if I mess up, right? I may find another technique. Well, who thought of that? Right? Like I said, this technique was a total mess up. I was doing ATCs for all, and they had a swap, and I always loved the way the encaustic wax, how they used to do those cars, and I was just fascinated. And one time they had a swap, And I was like, I'm just lurking because I don't have those waxes. They're too expensive. And so the hostess told me, she said, wait, you can do it with crayons. So I kind of did the technique, you know, with crayons. And then I was just trying, and I didn't like some things. You know, I was trying to send my best work, so I gave it a try like 6 times. And I end up with some horrible stuff. And I was like, well, you know, I can probably use them. And then they used to call the collage-a-thons, where they do it like over the weekend. Yes, I do have 9 caustic. I finally was able to afford them. So anyway, so then we used to have another thing where we had collage-a-thons where people just work over the weekend. They do ATCs and then they trade. So me, you know, I'm trying to be a little fast, and I was trying to do a collage cards, and I was trying to be fast and beat them because there were some people were just making, and I wasn't able to make enough. So I was like, I'm going to be smart, and I'm going to use this background, and I'm going to put an image on top of it, and then I'm going to put big wax, and I'm going to call it done. So, well, things didn't go quite that way. So when I was putting the wax on, it just got really, really thick. So I thought, and my image was almost ruined. So anyway, so then I flipped over the collage card I had, and I ironed, and I said I can put the iron on and try to remove my image. Well, it was so thick, and I just had wax everywhere. So I started wiping it off, and I was almost in tears because I ruined the card. And then I looked and I said, oh my God, look at this. This is cool. So that's how the melted crayon technique was born. So anyways, I don't want to bore you guys with my stories. So yes, Mitzi, I bought some encaustic wax and I have not tried them yet. So I just hope I don't get disappointed, that's all. Oh, you're welcome, Rusty. So they want me to do, find something. And it doesn't really matter what colors you use. So, what am I in the mood for? Maybe I've been in a mood for a lot of browns. I don't know why. Seems like browns been my, but you have to be sure that you have at least 3 colors for that technique, so. So I'm going to experiment with the 2 that I had out already. So I'm going to use this 3. I think this is gold. So it may not work. So I'm going to use yellow, I guess. Yeah, I don't know. I've been doing a lot of browns. Maybe I'm like, I don't know. Maybe I'm going to a brown period. So, yeah, everybody knows me for using very, you know, brights and. So. There we go. And I still have black from my previous, so hold on a second. I might have to clean this. So let's try again. Nothing to it, right? Oh, I was off camera.
Sorry, guys. Let me do it again. Doesn't matter. Do it over.
Still
off camera. It'll happen to the cramps. I think they don't want me to use browns. Is that what it is?
No, thank you, Dar.
Yeah, that was a little off camera. But this is what I came up with. So okay, I'm gonna use pinks. And a lavender.
Where's Dart? Did Darcy go to sleep?
She must have been tired, huh? Poor girl. She did a wonderful, wonderful job though today. Alright, so I'm gonna use different colors.
Say brown
does make bad art. Actually, the car I made with brown steampunk boot.
Okay, here we go. I already see something, but I'm not gonna say what. So I'm waiting to see somebody tell me. Because I already see what I see. You see something, Jean? You do not see a face, darling?
Wow. Gotta show you. Alright, here we go. I don't want to be off camera.
Okay, Jean saw it. Oh, you saw your two eyes? I only saw one. You didn't see that, Myra? For the choice of butterfly. Well, I mean, you can see what it's not up to me what I see and it's what you see.
of course, you know, this is just my first, and I have to kind of fix it and make it proportional. Right now, this is the first thing I saw, so it's not proportional, but you know, that's how you work the details. So let's try the other one, the one that I was a little off focus from the camera. And there are times that you have to turn this. Oops. You know what? I didn't use Bristol. I used the chipboard. So there is no color. Oh well. Let's try again. This time. We're gonna try to make mud. See, Jean? He couldn't even. So if you saw you couldn't draw, yes you can. It's all about practice. So here we go. This is when people get scared, when you have, let me get on camera. So you have pink and you have a light brown, and then you have this cool color here that is probably gonna mess up everything and make mud, right? Right, Jean? And that's what you get scared of when you mix those kind of two colors together. So, see, when you see my iron is smoking, so when you see it smoking, you have to turn it lower, because you don't want those fumes. And I have my windows open. All my windows are open. Because you don't want to breathe the fumes. Is that what you're saying, Jean? Mud? Well, let's try it. And I'm not saying I will make mud. I probably will too. Is that mud? I think, Jean, what you've been doing, you were probably doing this. And I use a one stroke, a long stroke, when you put in your colors. Is that it? I'm gonna use just one color now, just to cover my white areas. So, same. I use that green and brownish and pink. You say you had orange and purple. Okay, we can give it a try. No, I remember, Jean, when she first tried it, that she was always saying that she was making mud. And so I was trying to figure out how. So away. Oh, this one is a little bit. Ooh, I know. This one I may have to turn different directions. I didn't see anything the first time around. So, let me see. I still don't see anything. There are times that I don't find anything. And it's not a, that becomes a background. Then it becomes just a background page. If you guys see something, let me know. See a parrot? Yeah, kind of see a bird or something there. You see a person with a red coat. I don't see it. It's not talking to me. Oh, can you stop on top? Yeah, yes you can. Just have to prime it. Have to prime it with the eraser. Just take some elbow. So if you want to stamp on top of the crayon, I found it, you probably Stason works better for that technique. But I'm going to give it a try with Martha-SeekingforArt. Or versifying, I'm sorry. Yes, you can use any white eraser. And right now it's real yucky because of the black I was using. But you can clean it with sandpaper too. The eraser. Yeah, it's a stippler, but you can, it's, I don't think it matters as long as it's a white and hard eraser. So, yes, Midnight, that's what I have found. The Bristol has been my best choice for this technique. I mean, you can use other papers and it may be some different effects. Sorry, just gonna be sure this is going. This is more slick now that it has crayons. I can still see it wet. So, it'll work, you just need to let it dry. Gee. Yeah, music is talking to Gene here. Right, Gene?
there's another way of using the technique. I mean, there's many ways. There's no right or wrong. All right, Dar. There's no right or wrong. I mean, Jean did a whole stream just experimenting different techniques. What paper would have worked better, you know, and black and white and... So what did you find out, Jean, as far as papers would work the best? Because I tried watercolor paper and it just... Yeah, that too. Yeah, you can carve stamps on those erasers. You see a praying hands. Well, there you go. There you go for the joy. You can start doing some drawing with the melted crayon. Okay. Yeah, metallics are good too. The only thing I found when I removed the wax, a lot of times, a lot of those metallics kind of go away when I'm taking off the wax. Oh, really? Magazine board? Well, that's cool. So, anyways, this needs to get dry like overnight. I don't think it'll... Yep, that would be the Jean technique. Yeah, but I think for this, you're probably better off with a stay-on to stamp on top of it. The VersaFine will work, but you just need to let it dry. Yeah, for leaving the wax on metallics is the best way. Yeah, that technique that you're talking about, Jean, that's most of the encaustic. When you're trying to make, I think if you use the, what is it called? Where you used it, the alcohol inks, that glossy paper. That one kind of gives you that technique when you can create shapes and with the iron. This one absorbs it, so it doesn't really does it for you. I think it will become like kind of like this one right here. I think this is a little smoother than that. Let me use another color. I think this is what you're talking about, right? Oops. So are you feeling better, Dar? So that's what you're talking about, That's what you're talking about, Jean? How the kind of get, I don't have the right paper, but I know where you, this is more kind of like the encaustic, where you can do shapes and different things. Yeah, this one you can do glossy paper, probably the best bet when you want to do the encaustic techniques, because you can really make shapes and actually can draw with the wax. Oh, thank you, B-Button. Thank you for stopping by. Sure, no problem. Oh, hi, Jamie. Jamie, did you do your coaster when we were in Austin? I just can't remember. I know there were a few people that didn't do it, and some people were really trying to do Rose's challenge. Yes, Deb, it's lots of options with this technique. You can go on and on and on and on. Like I said, I have mixed many mediums with it. And there's still a few that I haven't tried, so I'm going to see if I can come up with something different. So, is there any other questions for me? Like I said, if you have not seen this technique, oh, good, Jamie. Yeah, I wasn't sure because I knew there were some people working on the Rose's challenge, so I wasn't sure if you did it or not. And it's hard, you know, like Annette probably couldn't do it, so that's the reason I gave her my sample for the class. Because there was just no way she can work with a hot iron on her lap. So, it has some, you know, it is a great technique, but I understand that not everybody can do it. Oh, you're welcome, Myra. What weight, darn? Yeah, you are. I think a lot of people in the lab, because I'm like waiting. I'm saying something and I'm waiting for somebody to tell me something, and I don't see anything. So this is the one we did on. They chose the birdie to do the coaster. Oh, you want me to try the new wax? Alrighty. I haven't even opened it yet. So, let me take a little break. I'll be right back. I'll get the new waxes. So, if you guys need to take a break. I'm taking me a 5-minute break, so I'll be right back. Sorry, I thought I left you not on focus.
Oh, you put me another challenge, huh, Dar? So let's see. I've never tried them before, so they were just out of reach for me. So they supposed to have more pigment than the crayons. And we're about to find out. I'm gonna have to save the labels so I know what colors I have if I decide to buy more. Candles. I'm not sure if candles would work. I'm gonna do red, and I didn't buy that many colors. I only have 8 colors, so but it came in the kit, and then I bought a few extras. You think so, Eileen? Have you tried them before? I know Dar has some. And I've seen some wonderful, beautiful work with them. But I was using the porcelains and caustic waxes. Let me see if my iron is hot enough. Okay, I don't know if you guys, I'm out of focus here. I'm trying to have to keep something close to me so I don't get out of focus. Yeah, I've seen Lori's. But it's very abstract, so I'm not sure. We'll see. So I got do you want me to do kind of like use the encaustics and then use the crayons? Yeah, I'm using Bristol. I can probably see if I can find some of the glossy paper, because I think glossy works better with that technique. So you want me to try crayons on Bristol also, or? But like on another color next to it to see what difference. Well, I can use another paper. So you guys want me to do crayons also? I don't know. Yes, it's the glossy paper, the one you use for the encaustic. You're right. But since I wanted to use acrylics and pencils, I decided to use Bristol for my technique. So anyways, let me see if I can find a red and a yellow, kind of like the same color combo. So I think that matches that one. Oh, really, Eileen? Well, I've used Bix Wax for my acrylics. I know I have that. Yeah, here we go. So you guys think those two colors and these two colors are kind of the same? I just want to try to see the difference. So I'm gonna do it, even though it's probably not the same thing we were trying to do. So I'm gonna do the same colors. And I'm gonna do it over here. Oop, I think I put more red than yellow. They mix different. I think the red overpowered the yellow on this one with the crayons. The red kind of overpowered the yellow. Oops, where am I? There we go. So can you guys see the two differences? I don't know, maybe do we have the lag or nobody's really talking to me? I think so. I think it took a little more. The crayon probably has more wax than the encaustic. Okay, I'm throwing that next. Just trying to be sure that you guys look with me because I think it's the lag. Okay, so this is encaustic and this is crayon. See, not that much on my napkin. So that tells me there's probably more pigment than wax. Now let's try the see the difference. The crayon has probably more wax than the encaustic. Oh, bye, Vicky. So I'm waiting for you guys to see the so I can hear the feedback. See, this is the crayon, what I got off the crayon. This is the encaustic when I try to remove the wax. Any feedback? And this is my result after I wiped it off. Yeah, it seems like it's a lot less wax on this, it's more pigment. And the red empower the yellow with the crayons than I did
for the encaustic. Does it look closer now?
I'm just going to try one color, so I'm going to try this one and that one. So this side is going to be crayon, this side is going to be encaustic, okay? I still got red from the when I was melting it. I know I'm probably off camera again. Hold on. Oh, hi Darcy, welcome back. Yeah, I bought some encaustic crayons when we were in Austin. So I'm trying to. Now I'm just. Dart asked me to get them out and play with them. Okay, so I'm going to use crayon first. What do I think? I would need to probably try some of the other techniques to see how the colors and the acrylics react to the wax. I think that's probably what I need to kind of test. I tell you what, you can't color on the paper with this. Not very much. And you see it doesn't melt like the crayon. It's different. And it has a smell like, it smells like beeswax when I'm melting it too. It smells like beeswax. So I wonder if I use beeswax and just some pigments. If I can do my own. So let's see again. This is encaustic. Trying to get a nice clean area. I got that much. This is the crayon. So this is crayon, this is encaustic. I think I had a little bit of red in this one though. Do you see a face already? So let's try some I'm gonna try some pencils. And I'm not doing anything fancy, I'm just trying. And then I'm gonna use the encaustic. It smells like beeswax, I'm telling you. I must be crazy. Ooh, it smear a lot. Guess I'm missing something here. So this is the encaustic. And this is crayon over here. Kind of smear too, so. But over here you see it more. Because here, if I keep taking it off. So. Hold on a second, put this on the floor. So this is encaustic. And I had a kind of like a teal or green teal pencil. And I see my color smear a lot more than it did with the crayon, the color pencil. Oh, really, Ellie? Yeah, I can smell beeswax. So, I wish I would have bought that, well, at least one stick of that pigment that they had. But I didn't. So I need to just try to find it online and see what can I do. We'll just experiment. So what do you guys think? I think the crayons. I think so too. So, there's no right and wrong. I mean, this is my technique. I know the encaustic has to be used in a different way. So, I would just wanted to try them. So.
Yeah, I think so, Jean. I think the crayon is probably
good enough for what we do.
I think so too, Eileen. I think it has more pigment. Yeah, and these are meant to use differently, so I'm just fascinated with wax. So I was gonna give it a try. And like I said, I like it because I can do so many different things. So, I mean, to do this just with plain acrylics, it would take forever. It would have been, let me see if I can get the camera not as close anymore. It would have taken a a lot of different glazes to get this effect instead of just using the crayons with all the. Hold on, I can't read the chat. Let's see, Jean, see how Oh, that was a good price. $8 for a box of 8 bars. I pay almost $70 for it. So, see, but see what I like about the melted crayon is because I can use, I think this one was the oil sticks, the Shiva oil sticks. I use that and then I use my pencil. And this is acrylics. This is my white paint for the lines. This is acrylics. I did spray with Lindy's. I know you can see the specks, the brownish. I spray with Lindy's before I even put the wax, so just to get those specks, brown specks on it. And it is a lot of the details, and those are Shiva sticks, the green on the stamp. But see, look, I mean, I just get amazed with just the variation of colors. So look in this area right here, just all those mixes of those crayons and doing this thing and gave that cool effect. So, I mean, you can't really go wrong. And I did put some of the blue because I need a little more blue, so I did add a little more blue, but that was acrylics too. So, but the crayons did most of the work. I didn't do, to me, the background, it was the crayon that did the work. Oh, thank you, Mara. And see, and this one is more of the kind of like the encaustic technique. But this is done with crayons too. And this is the same thing, like kind of like what Jean was talking about. Letting the in this one, most of it is most of it is crayons. The only thing I did, somebody asked me if I have gesso the paper before and then use crayons, so it kind of, that's what I did. It did kind of the encaustic technique. So I think this probably would be a good try with those encaustic waxes to do something like this. Yes, Jean, there's plenty of YouTubes on encaustic. And that's how I, like I said, that's how I got started with this other technique, because I went into a swap doing that, trying to do that technique. And I just stuck with mine. Because it was different. Sorry for the glare. Thank you, Dar. But I think this probably be a good candidate to do this kind of thing with those waxes. But like I said, this one, the only thing I used was the Sharpie. That was it. And the gesso at the bottom, you know, I primed the paper first with gesso. And just the Sharpie and the crayons. That's it. That's all I use. You were trying to clap, Dart. And this is something I do, like what you guys learned today, you know, when I was doing this. Just, I use a lot more acrylics on the dress and the ribbon and the lips. But this is kind of the same thing that we were doing today. Thank you, Dar. But same kind of technique. Just taking your time and working the details. But he was fun. I just wanted to show you guys that you can do a face in no time using the melted crayon. Oh, thank you, Darcy. And I don't want to bore you guys showing you, but this, I'm just trying to show you examples of how you can use this technique. That's all. That's what I'm trying to do. It's not 39, 23, 52, 33. What, are you trying to win something? Dark? You only get one chance anyways. Which one? This is just a few of the work that I have kept. I mean, I've been... Thank you. I have given away so much art with melted crayon. Yeah, but I'm trying to find out which one she's trying to win. Jean, what's that trying to win? I'm not sure which one. Is it this one? This the one you want?
did you guys ever, I know dark, okay, but I'm going to show you. These are stamp images. This is what was in Somerset. These are the originals of what was in Somerset. If I can find them all. Okay. So, this is not a stamp, but this is the yard. So this is a stamp. This is what I had when I got published in Somerset. All I did, I had an ATC with this one. And the image is not as big. I kind of extended the image. I think the image ended like right here. And so I sent an email to the editor and I said, you know, I'm doing this technique and would you like, you know, so I'm just trying to see if you're interested. And I had a whole lot of different things that I've done. I mean, I've done puppies, cats, you name it. Crows, people, anything I've been doing with the melted crayon. So they saw the Frida and they said, so, well, if you want to submit the Frida, you know, we will consider. I mean, they didn't say we will, they said we'll consider. So they put up, I got to work. So this was the first one. And like I said, I extended, I think the stamp went like down here, yeah, because the necklace, it was part of the stamp. But the dress wasn't, and the flower wasn't, and of course that Sacred Heart wasn't. And it says, mi jardín sin Diego, which just means my garden without Diego. And I was mixing, you know, the melted crayon and pencils and acrylics. So it was a true mixed media, and it was a stamp image too, so true mixed media. Some hand-drawn stuff, but still, you know, the main image was stamp. And then I did this one too. So, and I had stamps, you know, stamp, acrylics. And the editor, when after she received them, you know, she sent me a nice email saying that I took the stamps in another different level. So they are stamps. Yeah, she did, but gave me a nice compliment saying I took the stamps into a dot, and, you know, to a different level, so. And I think this one's I stamped over. I didn't stamp before, I stamped over. That's why it's a little smear on the stamp. So you can see the details on the image. And this one was a print. This was a print. I printed it out of, I think I did like a, it was her picture, and then I used Photoshop to give me like a stamp image, and then I printed it. And this one, I was trying to represent my take on when she cut off her hair, you know, when she was so disappointed at Diego, and she cut off all her hair, and it says, yo no soy tu pelona, so I'm not your short-haired girl. So, well, I remember when I first went to ATCs for All, I did a Frida, just, you know, because I've always been, I don't know, her story just kind of moves something in me to want to make it, you know, wants to make me do art. And at that time, I was just doing collages, but I remember when my first Frida card, I posted a few other cards, but when I posted my first Frida,
I had so many people asking if they could trade with me. So it was a big compliment for me, especially starting in a new site with, you know, thousands of people in a site and wonderful artists too. So I'm trying to turn off the yarn because I can smell it. So for me, that was a big compliment. And after that, everybody was, every time they would see me, they was like, Martha, can we try a Frida card? And I was always asked to do Frida. And then I felt like that's all I was doing was Frida. And I said, wait a minute, I want to try to do other things. So, but she's been good to me. I mean, I could publish. What else can I say, right? What else can I say? Frida got me published is with a melted crayon, you know. What else can I say? I mean, I'm so some thrill. This was a class I did at ATC's for All. I did the crow. So if you guys can see, this is embossing. It was UT first and then melted crayon. This was stamp and then melted crayon. And then I also was using tape so I could get, I wanted just to get the colors and I didn't want to, you know, be a smear with the other ones. So I was using painter's tape to be sure I had those lines. And then we painted the crow. And then we collaged the crown. So it was an extensive class. So this was another class I did at ATC's for All. And I know Dar was when I did this girl. Also in a class at ATC's for All. Even though she didn't do it, but she was there helping me out. So, and this one was 2009. And this one was 2011. So, I hope I'm not boring you guys. Blah, 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 blah. But I am going to play with those encaustics. Even though I still favor the crayons, I'm still going to, I mean, I can't. I spend a lot of money, so. Yeah, she's a great friend. We clicked from the minute we saw each other. Even though she was kind of punky the first time I met her, but then I got to know her better. She had the red hair too going and everything. And I'm more of the quiet type. Yeah, I'm more of the quiet type, so I was a little more, you know, kind of low key. And Dar was with the big boys. Oh, great, Bart. Yeah, I had dinner early, so I'm not really that hungry. So anyways, what else have I done? I know Dar talked about the hand swap we did one time. And I just couldn't let this one go. This one's where, like, I gotta keep my hands. Oh, hi, Diane. Oh, thanks, Carol. I know, you guys talking about going to UK and not inviting anybody. Darcy and Diane. So yeah, this was this. We did hands and I just couldn't let this one go. It was just like, I gotta keep this one. So So these are my art hands that I kept for me. Thank you. Anyone can come? Alrighty then. Yeah, Dar, they said anybody can go, so we invited. Yeah, they didn't even invite Jonna. Jonna was like, what? Can I go? Can I go too? I know, when it's more people, then it gets, I mean, the preparation and trying to get everybody synchronized and everything, it takes a lot. I know it does. And Brynn did a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful job when we got together in Austin. And I know it takes a yep, I know, but it's, you know, you get a group of 20 ladies, it's a job to get everybody in sync and everybody trying to do the same thing and try to stay in the same hotel and transportation and food, and I mean it's a lot of work. Like, so what part? So what you're saying, Darcy, like you would fly in into London? Well, that's true. You can travel. You can hire a travel agent and let them do the work. I know you rocks. Brynn rocks. Love you, Brynn. Thank you for having us. And Annette also. Their hospitality was just so awesome. And don't forget about Dawn, baby girl. She was also awesome. So anyways, guys, I don't know what else. I think I'm pretty much have shown a lot of yeah, we can do all the cities, yep. That's right. To go see Rachel. If she wants us. Yep. So, I don't think it would be that expensive, would it? If you go around April, not during the summer break. I know, I was supposed to go with ATCs for all too. A group of ladies went to, where did they go? They had a trip too, also to England I wanted to go so bad, but I had something else came up and I just couldn't go. So, LOL, Diane. Happy Diane. Yes, you won. You won the race. Okay, gang. I think I'm done. And I'm going to try to stream some other time. If you guys don't get tired of melted crayon. So, if you guys still want to continue more tricks. So I'm going to say goodnight, and I have a big mess on my table that I have to clean. So thanks a lot for stopping by, and Dara, I hope you're feeling better, and I hope I was able to do what you do best. Okay, so you guys would art along next time. All right. All right. Thank you, girls. Love you.